Good evening, and welcome to AP US History Exposed. I'll be your host for the evening, Jacques Pictor. Tonight, we'll be exploring the fascinating world of the beatnik. I'd like to introduce you to a group of subjects I've been observing for an extensive period of time.
Katie Leisner, shown here, demonstrates that beatniks were often found amongst nature, getting in touch with their inner selves. As Becca Chase shows, many beatniks were concerned with the strength of women in society.
I am a rock. I am an island. And a rock feels no pain. And an island never cries.
Amber Cup, seen in this clip, is an excellent example of how beatniks maintained a very natural diet, and how many even grew their own food. This next subject, Andrew Leinberger, shows free-spiritedness being a major trait of many beatniks. They tried not to let the daily grind get them down. And lastly, Jenny Justad shows us that the beatnik attitude was very anti-conformist, even when it came to painting. Many rejected paintbrushes altogether and used unique means to demonstrate their unique ideas.
I call it evolution of man!
Beatniks faced many obstacles in maintaining a serene lifestyle. They were constantly harassed by the squares, or people taking part in mainstream culture. Still, they maintained their haughty attitude toward those who didn't understand their beliefs. Jack Kerouac was a major driving force behind the Beat movement and inspired thousands of abstract poets throughout the U.S. Hallucinogens such as LSD were often used by beatniks to expand their spiritual state of mind. Groups of beatniks would often congregate to partake of these substances.
So, are you a bird or a mammal?
Well, I'm a mammal.
But why do you lay eggs?
It's been that way for millions of years.
Yeah, I guess that's true.
Yeah. Do you have any other questions?
Are you Jesus?
Yes, I am Jesus.
Oh, cool. Can you tell me the meaning of life?
No, it's a secret.
Okay.
Boy meets girl where the beat goes on. Stitched up tight, can't shake free. Love is the drug God has put on me.
What a fascinating group of people. Well, that's all the time we have for this edition of AP US History Exposed. Join us next week when we'll be discussing Chicago and the rubes who call it home.
Catch that buzz. Love is the dog I'm thinking of. Oh, can't you see?